Hey, Mountain Church, it's great to see you once again in our life group vids. I know you guys are rallying together in your homes and having a meal and just enjoying each other and loving each other and praying for each other. And in this series where we're going through the warnings of the Word, there's one that Paul really points out in Colossians chapter 2. Super important for us. Let me ask you before we get into that, though, is do you remember back when you first came to Christ, you first placed your faith in Christ? Maybe it was at one of our outdoor amphitheater services downtown. Maybe it was in the sanctuary at Mountain Church on 1 East Main. Maybe you got saved at a crusade or someone led you to the Lord on the streets or whatever it might be. There was that time where you first placed your faith in Christ and everything was so simple. It's like, yeah, Jesus came, He died, He rose again, He died for my sin, I believe and I'm saved. And Paul the Apostle talks concerning those of us who've placed our faith in Christ. No matter how long we've walked with Him, he says this, remember when you accepted Christ, Colossians chapter 2, verse 6. Remember when you accepted Christ as your Lord? He says, now you must continue to follow Him. In other words, stay your course. And then he says, let your roots grow down into Him. So he says, follow Him. You came to Him. Now let your roots grow down into Him. And then he says, and let your lives be built on Him. So right out of the gate in these first few verses, we just see this constant, trajectory of let's be about Jesus. Our life is about Him. Our faith is in Him. We're putting our roots down into Him. Our lives are built on Him. And then he says, when we do that, when we have our eyes on Jesus, he says, our faith will grow strong in the truth that we were taught, and we will overflow with thankfulness. In other words, Christians, keep it simple. Keep our eyes on Jesus. Keep putting our roots into Him. Keep our focus on the work of the cross and the resurrection and the wonder of who Christ is. And then in the same context, in the same breath, he says this, and this is the warning. He says, don't let anyone capture you with empty philosophies and high-sounding nonsense. Empty philosophy and high-sounding nonsense. Paul says there's going to be those that are like, that's great, you got saved. That's cool that you placed your faith in Christ. Now, what you need to do now is you need to go deeper into this philosophical way of thinking. And you need to choose a side on this particular philosophy of ministry and this philosophy of theology. And you got to pick what group you're going to be in. There's a division in the camp of the church that is recycled once again, has been for thousands of years now. And that is, well, hundreds of years for sure. And that is, there seems to be this philosophy of man that creeps into our theology of the study of God. And that is, there's this idea that we have to choose a camp, one being that God is totally sovereign, that He has foreordained everything to happen, that He has selected the elect, that He's chosen, and that's all true. He is sovereign. He has done those things. He is all-knowing. Of course, the Word is explicit about the sovereignty of God. And then there's this camp over here that says, well, God kind of put things into motion, and He just lets man make decisions along the way. And He really kind of like a watchmaker. He created it, He put it into motion, and then He kind of just let it play itself out. And there's these two camps, one being kind of the Calvinist camp, one more the Arminian camp. And they fought with one another for so many centuries now. And it's creeping back into the church once again. I've seen it cycle through several times over my decades of walking with the Lord. And what happens is we end up in these circles where people feel like, you have to choose a side. Are you an Arminian or are you a Calvinist? And if you're a Calvinist, you believe these certain points, these five or seven points. and you're hardcore about all of these things, and that God is totally sovereign and absolutely is foreordained, and he has all foreknowledge, and he's selected the elect and all of that, and in that he has no room to give man a choice. And so there's this hyper extreme on either sides of this. I bring that up to say, it's exactly what Paul's talking about in Colossians chapter 2. He's saying, keep your eyes on Jesus and be careful that you don't get pulled in, or don't let anyone sway you, capture you with empty philosophies and high sounding nonsense. The reality is that no man can counsel God, and no man can fully understand him and give him counsel. And so when we read the scriptures that talk about God being all sovereign, we believe God is all sovereign, 100%. And he's foreordained everything, and he's beyond our understanding. But also when we run into scriptures that say, all who call on the name of the Lord are saved. Anyone that believes in his heart and confesses with his mouth that God has raised Jesus from the dead, he's saved. And that puts the choice in man, but God is foreknown. And how that all works out, nobody knows. Nobody can understand. Nobody has the mind of God in that type of way. And so I encourage you as believers, set your eyes on Jesus. Get your feet grounded in Christ. Look to him, build your life on him, live for the kingdom, and be careful of the divisions of high-sounding nonsense and those things that are empty in philosophy. Stay in the Word. Keep your eyes fixed on him. Be a student of God's Word and just simply believe, and you'll be on really, really good ground. You'll be building your life on solid foundation. So God bless you guys. I encourage you, man, just keep your eyes on Jesus. Talk about these things tonight or today as you're rallied together in your life group, and maybe discuss what some of those high-sounding philosophies or that high-sounding nonsense is in your circles, and how important it is to keep our eyes fixed on Jesus. We'll see you this next weekend.